Hello everyone, welcome you all. In this video, we will see what is the use of static keyword and how to use it in our JavaScript programming. So let us understand what is the use of static keyword. So first of all, we have already discussed about classes and object concept in my previous video. So when I create one class, right, what class contains? Class contains the variables and methods, right? So I can create any number of objects for the class, let's say object one and object two, object three. I can create any number of objects for single class. So when I create an object, what will happen is the object will acquire their own variables and methods, and every object is independent. So every object will acquire their own variables and methods and their own copy of the variables and methods. So which will occupy certain amount of memory here. Object two will occupy another amount of memory, and object three will also occupy certain amount of memory. So as many objects we created for the single class, every object will occupy certain amount of space in the memory, right? So in this particular context, normally what happens is we create certain variables inside the class, and also we have created certain methods. So every object will acquire their own copy of the variables and methods. So this object one is also having variables and the same methods. And object two is also having same variables and methods, and so on. Every object is acquiring their own copy of variables and methods. And as I said earlier, class is a logical entity, whereas object is a physical entity. Now, in this approach, so let us assume a scenario. I have defined some variables and methods, and the values of those variables or the implementation of those methods exactly the same for every object. And this is a scenario. So let me repeat once again. When I create some variables or when I define some methods in the class, let us say I have some variable here, a equal to 100. Okay, a is equal to 100. So when I create an object for this particular class, every object is also acquired their own copy of the variable. So here the object one a value is equal to 100, and here object two a value is equal to 100. So here also a value is equal to 100. So when I declare the value into this variable at the class level, when I create an object, so this variable value is a constant across all the objects, and this is a common value which is there in every object. So later, if you want to change the value of the variable at the object level, we can make changes here. But when I add some value into this variable at the class level, after that, when I create multiple objects, every object, the default value of A is 100. Now in this approach, there is a problem. There are two problems. One is, so if you see here, whenever I'm creating multiple objects, it is occupying certain amount of memory, right? So here, even this variable also occupies certain memory, and the object two variable also needs some memory, and object three variable also needs some memory. And here, three times of memory it is wasting here. Three times memory it is allocating. And the one more problem is, suppose tomorrow I want to change the value of A. I want to change the value of A. So I need to change this value at the object level. So object 1 dot A equal to 100, object 2 dot A equal to 100, object 3 dot A equal to 100. So their default values are 100. So I want to change this value through this object. And suppose let us assume this value is a constant for all the objects, right? And tomorrow, if I want to change the value in one place, and that change should affect in every object. So that's my requirement here. So I don't want to change the value of A in every object. Just I will change the value of A in one place, and that will automatically affect in other places. Normally it should not happen like this. So for that, what we have to do is we have to make that variable as a static. So two problems we have discussed. So what are those two problems? One is every variable in the object level will occupy a certain amount of memory. So that's the one problem. The memory will be wasted. The second problem is, so we cannot modify the value in all the places at once. So we cannot modify the value in all the places. When these two problems occurred, if I create individual objects, and if the value of the variable is same, then these problems are there. So to overcome these two problems, we can define this variable as a static keyword. Or if it is a method also, it is applicable for method also. So when I create a method, let's say M1, I can make it as a static. So when I make a method or variable as a static, and these variable and methods are common across multiple objects, and it will create a separate memory, especially for this variable 100. and this one M1 method. So because we make them as a static, so this variable and methods are static. So as soon as we created an object, these things are common for every object. Now we don't need to modify this using objects. If you want to modify them in one place, that will automatically affect it in all the objects. And if you want to, let's say, and here we don't need to assign the value every time using object, because it will not occupy any amount of space here, because we already created this, and here itself it will occupy the memory only one time. So every time when you create an object, it will not occupy any other space, so it will save the memory. The other usage is, if I want to modify this value in one place and here at the class event, that will automatically affect it in all the objects. And one more thing is, if you want to access these variables or static variables and static methods, we can directly access by using class name. We no need to create any object. So without object also, we can directly call variables and methods. So this is a basic usage of static keyword. So whenever I define a variable or method as a static, so those variables and methods are common across multiple objects, and it will occupy memory only one time. It will not occupy many times at the object levels. Okay. Now, when I create a variable or methods as a static, so there are certain access level restrictions. Now we'll see how we can work with the static variables and methods in JavaScript. Let me just go to Visual Studio Code, and here I'm just creating a new file. I will name it as staticdemo.js. So once you created this file, so in this, what I'm going to do is, I will create a new class. Let me just create a new class, and my class name is test I am giving. So inside the class, I will define few variables. Let's say how to create a variables in the class. We don't need to specify let or where or any other keyword. Just we can directly specify the variable name equal to, I'll say 10. This is a variable. I'm also assigning some default value in it, and I'll say b equal to 20. So these are the normal variables or class variables. And if you want to make this a static, then we have to specify a keyword called as static. Now A is a static variable. This is a static variable. This is our static variable. Now B is a non-static variable. Now similarly, we can also create static methods and non-static methods within the class. So let me create one method called M1, and in this I will just print console.log, and I will just print something called, this is M1 static method, and I will make this as a static by adding static keyword. So in front of this method name, I can just add static keyword. Similarly, I will also create one more method called non-static method. That's a method name, and if I don't specify the static keyword, that is a non-static method. So inside this, I will say console.log. And here I'll say, this is M2 static method. That's it. So now I have defined two methods. One is static method, other one is non-static method. Similarly, one is static variable, the other one is non-static variable. Now let's see how we can access these variables and how we can call these methods. So as I said beginning, so static variables and static method we can directly call by using class name. So let us try this. So here the first point is, we can directly call, or we can directly access static variables and methods. Okay, we can directly access static variables and methods using class name. Now we'll see the practically. Using class name, we can access directly without creating an object. But normally, if there are any methods, we have to create an object for the class, and then through that object we can access these methods. So now let us try to access. So test is my class dot, I'm accessing A. So A is a static variable, right? So I'm just trying to print the value here. Console.log test dot A. So test is my class name, A is a static variable. And similarly, I will also try to access non-static stuff. Let's say console.log, and I'll say test.b, right? So now observe this, what will happen. See this, I'm directly trying to access A and B by using class name itself. Okay, I've not created any object here. Now let me just run this code, and now we can see the output. 10 is printed. So this is the output of the statement. Perfectly fine. A value is 10, which is a static variable. Now, when I'm trying to access the non-static variable using class, it is saying undefined. Undefined, because we cannot access non-static variables directly through class. So that is a flexibility we have only through class, only for static variables. So static variables we can directly access using class name itself. So we can directly access static variables and methods. So here I have tried to access only static variable, and we can also access methods. So let me try to access. I'll say test is my class dot m1. M1 is a static method I'm trying to access. Now let us execute this. So once we execute, you can see the undefined, this is a method is called. So this is a statement which is printed by this particular calling. This is m1 static method. So we are perfectly called m1 method from the class test. Perfectly fine. Now let us try to call m2 method dot m2 I'm calling. Because m2 is a non-static stuff, so it should throw some error. Let me clear output. Then again, run this once again. Now we can see it is saying an error. So type error, test.m2 is not a function. So why it is saying not a function? Because we cannot directly access non-static methods through the class. So this is error. All right, this is incorrect, first of all. This is incorrect way of calling method. All right, so what we have understood, the first point is we can directly access static variables and static methods using class name. We cannot access non-static variable and non-static methods using class name. But how we can access non-static stuff? So to access non-static stuff, we should create an object of the test class. Now let me just create. So the second point, we can access non-static variables and methods. Okay, non-static, I'm talking about non-static. So we can access non-static variables and non-static methods using object. Only through object we can access. Now let's create an object for test class, test t equal to. How to create an object for class? Let t equal to class name test. Now I created an object for test class. Using this object, I can access a non-static variable. Now let us try to print this. Console.log t dot b. Fine. So now I'm trying to access non-static stuff through the object. Right. So now similarly, I'll also try to access by using this object. I'm trying to access m2 method because m2 is a non-static. So previously, when I tried to access this b and m2 through the class or by using class name, it is giving an error. And the variable, it is saying undefined. When I call the method, it's saying in error, incorrect. But now I have created an object for the same class, and through object I can access non-static variable and non-static methods. Now let us execute and see. So when I run this code, so let me just comment these two, because these two are not correct, right? Or not this one, this one. This is not right statement, and this is also not right. Now this is the right statement because we are able to, we are trying to access non-static variable and methods through object. Now let's run this code. Now it is giving some error. What is an error? Let t equal to test. So we miss something here. So when you create an object, we have to use a new keyword, right? So then only it will create an object. Now let's clear and run one more time. Now we can see this is these two statements are output of this first statement is printed 10, perfectly fine. Now test.m1 is printed this message called perfectly fine because we're able to access static variable and static methods through class name itself. Now the second point here, we are able to access b through object. So it is printed b value, and we are able to access m2, which is non-static method, through object. So it is also able to call that method. It is also printed the output here, right? So these are the two points which we need to understand when you work with the static methods and static variables. So the thumb rule is, we can directly access static variables and methods using class name itself. And if you want to access non-static stuff, we must create an object, and through that object we will able to access, right? So why we need to use static keyword? Just for saving memory. And suppose if you want to modify this, for example, he is a static, So if you do some modification here, this is applicable for all the objects. And if you want to change this, we can change it using the class name itself again. So here we are able to access A, right? So we can change this value here itself. If you want to change this, we can do the change. So we don't need to modify the class again, right? So let's try to change it here. I'll say test, we can access that using class, right? So tester.a equal to, I'll make it as 1000, right? So again, I'm printing this. So before and after, two times I'm printing. Here I'm printing directly, and after I'm changing, again printing. So here, how we can change the value using class name itself. Now, execute. So now we can see here, let me just save it once again, clear. Right, so now let's try to execute. So it is executed. So you can see 10 is printed first, and then I have modified the A value, which is static variable, so that I can access through class name. And after modification, and again, I printed this value here. So it is printed 1000. That's the latest value. So after that, here we call M1 method, and which is printed here. And then here we call B value. This is 20. And then M2, which is non-static. Perfectly fine. Right? So this is how we need to work with the static keyword within the class in object-oriented programming. Right? So that's all for this video, guys. We'll see in the next video. Thanks for watching.